Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to a brand new game. Something that I'm going to include in my Let's Sample playlist. Not something I'm going to make a whole series on, not at this time. I don't really have time right now to commit myself to a long-term series, but definitely something that I want to bring to your attention is a game that's up and coming and should prove to provide hours and hours of one more click kind of fun. You know, you just can't turn this game off. I've been up way too late for the last couple of nights because of it. But if the graphics look kind of familiar to you, it's from the makers of Don't Starve. Oxygen Not Included is the name of the game. It's in either alpha or pre-alpha. Either way, it's quite early in its development, but a tremendous amount of gameplay is already here. There are a few little bugs that I've come across, but not enough to make you not want to play, that's for sure. And knowing where it's coming from Cly Entertainment, it's going to be carried through all the way to the end, and it's going to be a tremendous game. But it's a mashup, I would say, of several different games. Craft the World, if you've ever played that one, a lot of similarities to that. Of course, Don't Starve, in its graphics and sounds and all the little characters that run around. There's Dwarf Fortress in here, there's all kinds of different things, RimWorld. But let me just dive into a new game and we'll see how this goes. You can't get it yet on Steam, at least not as of the recording of this episode, but I hear it's coming soon. If you search the forum over at Klei Entertainment, K-L-E-I Entertainment, I think in there you will find a link to a way to buy it ahead of time. They're kind of waiting until the Steam release to really make it official. What do we have here? Three characters, potential. Kind of like the start of RimWorld. At least the old start. I haven't played the newest version of RimWorld to know what it's like to have more than three characters. Their traits, their pluses and minuses, what these mean. Night Owl does their best work when they ought to be sleeping. Flatulence, yeah, just full of it. Diver's Lungs, this is Oxygen Not Included. We run out of air in this game, so Diver's Lungs are actually a pretty good trait. Anemic, though, Athletics minus 5. Do a lot of running around in this game. Let's see here. Small Bladder and Diver's Lungs. Let's just do a reshuffle with all of this and just see what comes up. Scaredy Cat, what do we got? Can I do combat? I haven't yet to do combat, so tell you what, let's just go with this group right here. We'll make it happen. And what do I do? Name your colony? The Not-So-Starving Acropolis. Ah, why not? This is just a quick little let's sample, just show you how the game works. So let's embark. Now, basically, let me hit pause here at the beginning. We have been transported. Well, let me read it. Your crew has awoken miles beneath the surface of an unfamiliar terrestrial body. Oddly, they have no recollection of how they got there. It might be best to start digging. Doesn't give you a lot of hints of what you need to do, but you figure it out as you go. And, well, they do give you what you need to survive. This is oxalite. This makes air. It runs out. You need to be finding other ways to make air. You've got oxygen in these voids over here. All right. We got some water over here. More oxygen. This is a good map. More water and more water. Great. Vacuum over here. So when we dig to this point, it's going to suck the air out of the area and fill this in, which decreases the atmospheric pressure of the hole. There are ways to add that back in. This is actually a very good map. Very little bad space so far. Contaminated oxygen hiding over here. As we get further into the game, this fog of war is going to open up more and more. So, I paused? Oh, I thought I was paused. Oh, I'm wasting time. If you've played Don't Starve, this is your clock as the little planet turns around. Little night cycle right here. This is your pointer. Kind of, you know, as it goes around further, we're going to hit nighttime. So that'll be familiar to you. Tab works you through the speeds. Space is your pause. Your tools are down here. Dig, harvest, prioritize, which is really nice to have. Sweep picks up all the things they've dropped. Mop cleans up water spills. I've only had that happen once. deconstruct and cancel. It's pretty self-explanatory. All of your various buildings you can create, all the different objects, and information on everything in the map, sand, what it is, how it works, its details, its specific heat, capacity, thermal conductivity, mass. That all actually does come into play in little ways here and there. There are parts of this game I have never gotten to yet. I only just found slime last night. Anyway, we need to make oxygen. We need to make food. We need to make all kinds of things. So if you ever play Craft the World, it's very similar in those aspects, except you don't have the surface to go up to. This is entirely underground, and it stays that way. Let's get these guys doing something. We're going to need copper, and I have never used coal. Never had a need for it yet. But let's at least, dig tool. Exposed that far to get into some of the copper. This is vacuum. Let's not go into there. But we'll go this far here. As we dig these up, they become building materials, which allows us to do different things. Make ladders. Tiles are basically floor or walls or ceiling. So let's run a tile through to there. And I'm going to cancel that row. That's getting a little bit close to the vacuum to me. These little cells and what have you can crack. Sand falls, just like Craft the World, right? I think sand's unstable and falls. So, gotta be careful about that. Oxalite makes oxygen. Anyway, where to go and what to do? What is our strategy? This is oxygen. Let's open up into this void over here. Let's dig like so. Just basically giving them something to do for a while until I get far enough along to where it starts to make sense. We'll do something like that. Didn't mean to do that. Okay. So, could use some storage to put all this stuff in. Everything has some kind of a value to it. Storage container. Details? Expected more information here. It's not telling me. Is it here? Storage. Decor, negative 10. So, they are sensitive to... Let's see if it tells me. Here's all of their stats, each of your little peoples. They're sensitive to how ugly or pretty the environment is, and it affects their stress level. So right now they're all at zero stress. As they get stressed out, they have various... this one vomits when gets too stressed out, for instance. So you got to keep track of that as well. But storage over here, let's say we want to put all in there. It gives them a place to dump it in. If you were to sweep, you could order them to collect these particular ones if there was something there you really needed. What else? There's so many aspects of this game, it's hard to figure out what to talk about first. Rimworld will give you a sense of what this is all about. In order from left to right, and holding it over, it gives you their ability to do it. Digging, we're going to let them all dig. Who does good researching? None of them do. Okay, that doesn't help. Art, all right. Pierre is best at art, so we will turn off everyone else. So Pierre is the only one making masterpieces. Cooking, 4, 4, 2. I'd say these two could compete over cooking. Composting, research, generate power. I guess all of them are pretty low in their athletics. Yeah. Harvesting, we'll do that. Sweeping, let everyone do it. Building. There's one that's really good at it. Delver, digging. All right. So there's nobody that's really standing out as being the best at anything, so we're going to just leave it at that. Let's go through these right here. Ladder gets you up to another level. Let's do something like... Is that oxygen? It is. And let's let them build up into here all the way like so. And we'll see if they will dig that out. I'm pretty sure they will. You don't have to dig it out and then place the ladder in. I may be wrong there. We'll find out. As they can climb this and get up higher, we'll see if they interact with that space all on their own. Will they? They will not. Ah, there we go. Yeah, we're digging it out. Okay. So they're going to pop up into here. We get access to more stuff. We've got copper up here. We have dirt. There's dirt. We have these plants. Let's dig up bristle and blossom. Can we harvest anything here? No. That's harvestable. Okay, those are. We'll leave some of those. Anyway, we've got algae. We've got sandstone, sand. Everything has its use. As we get further into this, we'll start to see what those are. We got doors. Permeable gas tile. So instead of just a tile, it's like a vented one. So as you start to create rooms and levels, you can decide where you want air to flow through. You're going to start producing carbon dioxide right there. Unbreathable. It's heavier than oxygen. It'll tend to drift down toward the bottom. We've got here contaminated oxygen. It's something you can't breathe, you got to deal with. Eventually you get into equipment that will move air around. You get into equipment that will move liquid around. And pumps and ducts and pipes and what have you. There's so much here. Let's just move on through oxygen. This guy makes oxygen. It uses algae and water, I believe, to create it. And it also increases atmospheric pressure. And it runs until the pressure maxes out. So we could pop something like this in just to see how that one works. The algae terraformer converts carbon dioxide to oxygen. So you put that down lower somewhere as the carbon dioxide starts to accumulate. Put one of those in and it starts to convert it back over to oxygen again. Next tab, power. Manual generator. Where should we do this? I need to get... Let's do that stuff right over here. What was that? Toilets. Colony requires toilets and insufficient. Okay, we'll go through those in a moment. They're idle. That's probably what popped up, right? No, I thought there'd be three idle people there. Anyway, dig out this. And eventually we get into here. But tell you what, let's tile this up with... Well, I don't have a door. This is not a... without blocking the flow of gas or liquid. So putting a door here and then opening up into this won't help. It'll still move through. But this guy right here, which creates atmospheric pressure, will help to replace the void that's in there. We've got to power this guy. So power. Let's grab the manual generator, or the squirrel cage, which it looks like. And let's grab a tiny battery to put next to it. And then electric wires. We're going to connect from there down, shoot on across, and then up. And then from there up. That'll connect everything to the little outlet right there. And we're going to need copper to do all of that. What was that noise? We are nighttime. They've got nowhere to sleep. Yeah. I haven't given them beds yet. Sometimes they have the negative trait of snoring. And there'll be these sound effects blasting around them, and everyone else will wake up, and they'll be cranky the next day. Their stress level will go up because they didn't get a good night's sleep. So you got to kind of separate them out when you let them give them places to sleep. What was that? Was that a dream? I didn't see what Carl just did. He just jumped up, and something popped up over his head. Furniture will give you their basic cots. And maybe we'll do that up in here. I kind of like that. You need about this high per floor. Like that's 4 squares. When you get later, further into the game, you get a shower. The shower is 4 squares high. There's a few things that are 4 squares high. So let's toss in a floor right in here. Now you can bust up the oxalite. It will let out a burst of oxygen, which is one way to try to fill a void. But it runs out so much faster. It'd be nice not to do that so early in the game. Let's just let it naturally run out, and as it does, we will continue to build this ceiling across here. If they can't reach it, then you can toss ladders up, something like that. Allow them to be able to get up high and build a floor up here or something like that. Do that in Craft the World quite often. This one can go away. Let's deconstruct that one. That floor is going to go there. Let's go ahead and dig out. I'm gonna dig out this group right here. And as much of this as I can. That's good stuff in there. We'll be having here dirt, which they'll use for planters, and copper, which they'll use for wiring, and all the metal for the machines. So, among their jobs, one of them is power generation. That's the one who gets to run the squirrel cage here. Time to eat. We've got 21,000 kilocals? Kilocalories, I will guess, stored in here. And they're going to run out of that soon, so we've got to produce food for them. Let's toss some more floor across. Yep. Well, don't know if I... Boy, tell you, the WASD really swings you fast. I've got to really limit myself. I don't know how to slow that down. But I'm going to cancel the floor from there to there and not disturb these plants just yet until I'm sure about that. Up in here, I want to build some beds for them. We're just gathering more supply. Storage is already full. So let's go ahead and toss in... Temporarily, we'll toss these guys in right here. They need a bathroom. That's right. We got to get that one done. Plumbing right there. Outhouse. Let's just toss you back in this corner. And let's put a priority on that. Let me show you how the priorities work. One, do this way. Pick priority. Move over to the 9. Put it right there. That's a priority of 9. And man, he's got to go. Build that bathroom. Or I could have outhouse, click once, moved over to the 9 over here. And let's build a 9 priority bathroom. Outhouse is what we have now. Later we're going to have laboratories, we're going to have water pumps and septic systems and what have you. But right now we need to get that going, and they are going to be getting in line to use it. There's composting to do with what they have to clean out of that toilet. And in reality, we're going to need more than one. Oh, let's give him some privacy. Power, we've done that. And we can't do any more because we don't have any more copper. When we get into here, then these will all light up again. And that's one of the bugs that I came across last night. I got out to cycle 30, 32, somewhere in there, and could no longer... Made a mess. Uh-oh. Who made a mess? Oh, embarrassed. Yeah, couldn't hold it, and we've got some contaminated waters over here. Mop up. Okay. Anyway, that won't happen anymore. The outhouse is in. Copper, that's what I was saying. So this up here is your overall what you have available in your colony. Kind of like in RimWorld, it'll be down on this side over here. Raw metals. We've got 199.1 kilograms of copper. When I got out, you know, quite a ways into the game, I was mining copper and picking it up, and it was saying zero, even though it was in storage. Storage, that's right. You have to manually say, yes, I want everything. There we go. You can choose what goes into what storage if you want to spread it out. You, insufficient resources, you need algae. Okay, then let's get some algae going. Let's drop a ladder down over here. Something like that would do, and let's dig out under the floor and grab that and that. That'll get us started. We need to get research going also. Tell you what, while this ladder is here, let's throw this in to there. They can climb up to 2 levels at a time. So I think she could jump up and get up to here if this was missing and there was a space there. So 2 levels, their height is as far as they can climb on their own without ladders. So could not have reached this. The ladder will help them do that. Once this is done, we'll pull these out, and I'm going to put in a research station right there and show you how the research works. Otherwise, while that's happening, plumbing, we've got the outhouse, utilities, we haven't researched yet, food. This guy makes us some food. Let's go here. Yeah, I think that will be fine. We'll put food up there. Although food's being stored down here. Probably should have been right there. You know it should have. Cancel you. And that's not done yet. I'm going to reverse something here. Power. Let's put this guy right here. We're not truly... Well, we're just starting to use this. Okay, let's take a look at this. We've got... And everything in the game, you pass over it, it tells you about it. So, using algae... And we're just about hitting our max gas pressure. So when you've got a lot of carbon dioxide built up and very little oxygen, and yet it says you've hit your max gas pressure and it can't make any more oxygen because there's nowhere else to put it, then it's good to have some void to pop open especially if you can get it up high and down low, so it sucks any poisonous gases off the top and into the void, and any carbon dioxide pockets down into the void, like here, and out of the system too. But if we were to break this open, in fact, I'm tempted to go ahead and do it. We've got a way to fill up our pressure now. So let's go ahead and do that. Deconstruct. You can choose what to deconstruct when you've got multiple layers going on. We know we have wiring in here. We could very well have plumbing in here. Gas meaning air, or air gas. So the three different layers of medium that you can move through, plus the building itself, the flooring. So it lets you choose exactly what it is that you're wanting to destroy right here. Let's destroy that, and then let's dig out here. Grab us some copper, and we're going to see. In fact, let's see if we can see this. And here, blue is oxygen. Watch what happens here. There's nothing here. No color, meaning there's nothing there but vacuum. As we start to break our way through this, we're going to start to see a whoosh. Kind of fun to watch the graphics. The dark blue is breathable, but not as, not your highest end. So suddenly we're going to see a big mix going on here of the light blue turning to dark and then dissipating into nothing until we slowly start to work the air into there. This guy is going to start creating oxygen like crazy now because it's going to, still having a hard time. Okay, max gas pressure. So it's a slower process than I was thinking to move everything over. There we go. I expected that to be working like crazy right now. But you can see it is starting to move over, and they can move into this space now and be able to function without being harmed. Outside of that mode, that overlay, you can kind of get a sense of what's going on here. This is more breathable here than there. Other overlays... That's your gases, basically. They call it oxygen. You've got your power grid to see where all of your wires are that you don't normally see otherwise, as well as temperature. Temperature becomes a problem. You're in a closed environment here, so you don't want it to get too hot. And some areas, there's, closing in on 100 degrees there. You get down into some very hot areas. I've seen some in the many hundreds of degrees. We're not seeing any of that here. 110. We've got another daytime coming. Still 2,100 calories, so we're not hurting on food at the moment. Normally, I would have food completely up and running right now, but I'm doing more talking than I'm doing actually playing the game. Light overlay. This is your only artificial light source that comes with the game. You've got to come up with your own as you research. Speaking of, we need to get that going. So let's deconstruct this one so I can make. Let's see, let me get out of this mode. There we go. Deconstruct. Because I wanted to put... we're going to take this one apart. I wanted to put the food right here. So let's deconstruct these guys as well. Deconstruct priority 9. That one and that one. Let's clear this out. So as soon as they're done sleeping, they're going to come over here and clear this out. And we'll start food production right there. Let's set up some beds for them. We had 5 oxalite when we started. Now we're down to 3. It's starting to run out. So let's dig this one up. And I believe the more you expose, the faster it runs out. If you have a great big pocket of it and only one tiny little opening, then it's just going to leak out the one opening. But if you expose all the way around, it's going to go through quickly. But more flooring. Run this across to there. And beds, furniture. We're going to want one there. So let's get one built there and there. As they dig that out, which is going to happen right now, we'll put this one in. Okay. The floor's not in. There we go. Okay, they'll get to these guys, and there'll be a place for them to sleep. This has a timer. This is our printing pod. This creates new little peoples. I don't know what they call them. I don't know if there's a particular name for them. It's a printing pod, so are they prints? Don't know. But 300 seconds from now, we're going to see another one available to us. And that's probably a good time to end this episode. When the next one prints, and we'll see that process. Anyway, food. So What was that? I think there was some flatulence there. The microbe musher. That's our food source. And let's get wiring, power. That guy needs to be plugged in to the grid. This guy needs to be plugged into the grid. And we'll be able to research better batteries soon, and we'll get a much better battery. Batteries put out a lot of heat, so eventually you're probably going to want a battery room somewhere sealed off so the heat's contained over there and not into the general populace, general area. Some of these plants... Can I harvest that? Cannot. Some of these plants cannot grow in certain temperatures, and so it makes it harder to farm when everything gets too hot. And there are ways to cool them down. There are ways to move air around and dump the hot air in one area so that another area is cold. It's like air conditioning. Anyway, that's built. Beds are built. You can assign the beds manually if you want to. Who works here? Who lives here? If there's a snore, their bed's over here. when they get stressed out, these haven't yet, but when they do eventually, you'll be able to put in a massage table and assign somebody to it, and they'll go over there and get the best look on their face when they're laying there getting massaged. Nobody is even 1% stressed. I am so good to them. So that, well, I wish we had one of these in RimWorld. Whew! Anyway, food, power, this... I guess we can't reach that corner. We'll do it from the top. Let's destroy this. So, destroy priority 9. Get that out now. What else can we do real quick? A floor lamp. Alright. Gives you... improves decor opinion and reduces stress by providing light. Let's put that in right there just because there's plenty of access to power. Right there. Let me get out of that mode. Get into electricity. Right there. Hook you up. And they'll grab the copper. Now, how they do this, if you watch this, all kinds of nuts and bolts are... Alright, so we're... There we go. Throwing the nuts and bolts at it to build it. Boy, this moves so quickly. I can't move over a little bit. But they'll go and grab the materials. They'll run over and they'll throw the materials in. And then someone else will run over and build it. So depending on whether or not they are a... deliverer or a builder. In this case, all of them are, because none of them are good enough in any one of them to be, you know, the lead of that category. Cook. We want to fabricate. I don't think we have any of these in stock yet. We need to get plants up and going. So how best to do that? Let's throw a floor across here. Like so. Let's mine out priority 9 from here up and get some space, and we need to get research going. Keep talking about that. Let's throw some more flooring in priority 9. That's here, right there. Oops. And cancel those two. Let's dig again priority 9, just this group right here. Okay, and let's deconstruct that space. Get some height over here. And research is under stations. We've got, basically, at this point, I'm guessing that more is coming, but so far in the game, basically simple research and intermediate research, which tells me there is a hard or an advanced research coming, and maybe something beyond that. Once we get these guys going, we'll put him in right here, and probably this one in right here. And power, we'll charge up the battery, which powers all of these guys. Let's grab some power electrical wires, go from here down, and fire across like that. Later you'll have insulated wire, which doesn't release any heat. These put out temperature, put out some heat, which adds to the environment. Everything that runs basically puts out some kind of heat in the environment. So once these are up and running, and that's going to happen soon, plants, food, may as well downgrade the priority on this area and upgrade the priority over here. Let's get these in. We can't put planter boxes in to make food until we research it, so let's get that going. So they're going to stop they're going to complete the job they were assigned to, and then go search for the next 9 that is next on their list from this end to that end, depending on what that is. There we go. Somebody's going to be delivering lots of stuff. Let's move into here. You're building already. Somebody made a smell. Oh, they don't like the smell of the outhouse over here. There, we're dumping off parts. Kind of hard to see it. But they're spewing, it'll say here, delivered copper, 25 kilograms or whatever it is, of copper, which we have 6,000 of at the moment. So the wires are being built. Research is in. Okay. So the way the research works, no fabrications queued and no power. So we're waiting for power to come on. Prioritize 9. Power. And then each station has a priority. How often? Battery threshold. I'm not seeing this. Adjusts how much wattage should be used before reactivating the generator. Ah. Do you want them constantly keeping this thing topped off? Or do you want it to let it go halfway down so they can be off doing other things before they have to come back again? Otherwise, they'll sit here and spin the wheel all day long trying to go from 9.5 to 10 over and over again. But we're in. Let's do this again. All right. So, open research. What do we want to research? Farming gives us the algae terrarium, which converts carbon dioxide to oxygen. Compost takes the contaminated dirt, which comes out of the outhouse, into fertilizer. And this is our planter box, which grows food or medicine. I've not gotten into medicine before, so don't know how that works. But that was, do that again, research, novice research. Over here we get a bar of novice and a bar of intermediary. Over here, same thing. Eventually it's going to move into probably advanced. And so far we've got these topics to research. I'm going to guess that all this is going to be filled out when it's all done. But we have enough of the game going. So this right here is basically a unit of novice research. This particular one we want takes 20 of those units. So that's how they've chosen to designate that. We can either say, make us 4 of them right now, or we can simply say, make it over and over again. Continuous fabrication. And I want this one to be a 9. Where is that? That's the outhouse. Let's try this one. I want this to be a highest priority of the of their job tasks. That one gets done. And making power, another very high priority. And food, a very high priority. This is telling us we've got a new duplicant. That's what they're called, duplicants. We've got a new one available to us. And choose a duplicant is very similar to how we started the game, only we get to choose only one of them. Which of these do we want? Or reject all, wait for another full cycle, and another 3 will be given to us to choose from. So of this, we have Doris, early bird. Can't dig, though. Digging is done a lot. Unless she can do something else really good, like 9, plus 9 for digging. If she was a plus 9 for researching, you know, learning, that sort of thing. Though she is pretty good at learning. But plus 9 digging. I like that. They do a lot of running back and forth. Athletics is pretty important too. Slow learner, local, can't do research. Slow learner, everything is slow. I'm going to go with Ralph here. And one thing that this game will let you do, it will let you change names. So we can have different subscribers' names in here. Let's 0 what enter. There we go. Click him. He gets all excited. We want him. Print. And here is a little me. A mini me. So which means we need a new bed. Furniture. Cot. Right there. Stress. Hey, I came with stress. I'm all stressed out just recording this. Let's put me on the table and take that up to a 9. And watch what happens here. I'm right there, dumping off things, and I claim somebody else's bed. Is this the first night they've used the beds? I guess so. What's that game where you, musical chairs? Pierre missed out. Mm-hmm. Anyway, let's get through this night cycle. We'll see that and see what else needs to be done. Stations are in medicine. I have not had to use this yet. And there's no sense of their health that I've been able to... Oh, I've not noticed that. All right, health, 100% so far. Okay, so this will restore health. Otherwise, plumbing, refinements, don't have any yet. Medicine, stations, furniture, we've seen them all. And decor. A flower vase and a tasteful memorial. I've never lost one yet, so I've had to use that. Decor-wise, this area is great. This is really suffering over here, but especially I want it looking good where they are. This isn't going to work, and the floor lamp isn't going to work. We need to get further along when we get a canvas up in the air and can hover over the top. But I'm not going to disturb the oxalite at this time. What can I disturb? Here we go. Here's what happens when you get a massage and when you're building a bed and throwing all those wing nuts at it. But his stress is already down to nothing, and back to work again. What else to do? Battery is topped off. Research is happening. Food would be nice, but that happens when the research is done. Research, so far we have made 2 out of 20 units of novice research. So it's going to be a little while. We could set up a second one and get this done even faster. But there's always things for these guys to be doing. So it's kind of hard to lose 2 people to it. Eventually, until you get combustion engines going to replace the manual generator, you're going to need probably a couple of these eventually when you get 7 or 8 of these duplicates out here. And a couple of them spinning on the wheel to keep a whole bank of batteries going because you are spread out throughout the whole area doing all kinds of stuff. Ah, we got a whole bunch of contaminated water. That's what comes out of the outhouse. Or that's what happens when you don't have an outhouse. Contaminated air. You've got different devices you can create that deals with those. We've got lots of oxygen, lots of waters down here. So water is something we need to expose soon. In fact, that's right. I guess I didn't need water. The next one will. Let's do that real quick. I need to shut this episode down soon. But let's... You are fertilizer. Okay. Let's do... That. That. In fact, let's just run that ladder all the way down. Base ladder. Right there. Water's going to spill into this a little bit. Water level will level off. It's interesting. Water does tend to cling like that. Side of a... You know, you ever see water work its way uphill to the side of a glass. It's interesting how it, how they built that mechanic into this. I'm going to see what happens as we bust into this. Otherwise, there's not much more I can do until we get into further research. So I might play the game forward a little bit more to break into another research or two and then start recording again and give you more of a sense of other things that can be done. Holding the breath right here. A lot of carbon dioxide building up in this low spot. We'll deal with that one soon. As soon as the research is done, we'll have something that'll deal with that. Water's going to flow into this area, but now we have water available. They're going to start sucking up that water to put into the planters and to put into this guy when it comes up. The algae terrarium will take algae and water to convert this carbon dioxide back into oxygen again. So we're going to need access to water for that. Eventually, when we get into plumbing, we're going to... has to use the toilet, is going to pump water out to supply the plumbing and then pump it back into a place like this or into a filter that will filter it out and give you clean water, which will dump back into here again or here, depending on where you are at that time. Anyway, am I at a good place to call this one done? We haven't started food yet, but we're still researching. We've got to get through all of that. There's another half hour's worth of episode to get to that point. So I think I'm going to call this one finished right now. You guys tell me what you think of the game and go out and you know, either hang on until Steam releases it officially, or if you just can't wait, let you try to comb through that forum and find that little hidden link in there. Anyway, I will catch you guys later. Hit the like and subscribe if you would. Thanks for watching. Bye.